The influence of artificial intelligence across industries has been very impressive, and we've covered the most exciting ones in this channel. Today, you'll learn another way AI could be used to control important tasks on your computer. For example, surfing the internet for the best laptop deal. The basic premise is this. We spend a lot of time on our computers performing tasks like spreadsheet calculations, looking for products online, or filling out forms, to name a few. What if you could just type out exactly what you want to do and let the AI system handle the rest? Perhaps you want to purchase the cheapest ticket at a concert, or you want to find interesting places to travel without having to spend too much time searching. That would be amazing, wouldn't it?
Yeah, damn right!
Without wasting time, let's dive in. DeepMind, an AI company you're probably all too familiar with now if you've been following this channel, developed AI agents that can use keyboard and a mouse to control our digital devices. These actions are performed based on goals written in natural language by you, the user. The AI system learned to perform these tasks by training on the Miniwob++ dataset. This is a dataset of difficult web browser tasks for controlling a computer. These tasks range from simple button clicking to filling out complicated forms. The DeepMind team gathered over 2.4 million examples across 104 tasks from 77 people. This sums up to a total of 6,300 hours of computer tasks. A good starting point for the model to learn instructions and map them to actions on a computer. In order to learn the right actions, the team used imitation learning and reinforcement learning techniques. To break this down, let's first understand how AI systems use reinforcement learning. Reinforcement learning is based on a reward system approach, where points are earned by attaining a certain goal. For example, win a chess game. This is similar to rewarding your dog with a Scooby snack if he's a good boy.
Agent and the environment, and the conversation basically talks about what is going back and forth between the agent and the environment. So the environment is going to reveal itself to you, to the agent, in the form of states, S. You then get to have some influence on the environment by taking actions, A. And then you also receive back, before the next state, some kind of reward for the most recent state action combination.
In certain scenarios, it's hard to explicitly design what the specific rewards are in an AI program. Take this example of an AI agent being instructed to book a flight. There are several ways it can move the mouse and click on buttons to finally succeed, and hopefully, it doesn't book the most expensive first-class ticket with your credit card. In these complex cases, we need to provide the AI system with human examples so that it doesn't spend too much time learning ways to achieve the desired result. Learning from human actions is what we call imitation learning. A popular real-world implementation of this kind of AI learning is the human driving feedback Tesla uses to improve its self-driving capabilities. So, how does this translate into computer tasks? Well, the AI agent can learn the steps required to fill out a form, send an email based on your instructions, or even book an appointment for you. The research concentrates on developing methods that can, in theory, be used to train AI agents to solve any digital task. We've seen a rise in AI applications that simply allow us to type out our instructions, and then these instructions are followed to perform amazing tasks in areas like video, music, and robotic actions. Every day, people spend billions of hours using digital devices. Imagine a world of digital agent assistants where you're spared the low-level tasks and rather get to focus on much more intricate activities. Another company at the forefront of this technology is Adept. The company was founded by some former OpenAI and Google employees, so you know that's a recipe for great work to come. The team built an AI software assistant called ACT 1 that can interpret written or spoken commands. The team demonstrated how ACT 1 may be used in different scenarios. For example, finding a house for a family of four in Houston with a fixed budget. The AI automatically searches the website by typing in a search term and changing the search parameters until a house that matches the requirements appears on the screen. Other demos show interesting use cases across applications like Salesforce, Google Sheets, Craigslist, and Wikipedia. Act 1 is built using a transformer model. This is the same model used to build very large-scale language AIs powering important applications like Google Search. The name is also fitting, especially if you imagine this as a magic show, and if we wait till the end, we'll see the culmination of the act. The first version of the model can be added as a Chrome extension that can monitor the browser. The great thing about AI software assistants is that it can apply everything it has learned during training to other websites it may have never seen before. Thus, the AI understands what it means to drag an icon or fill all types of forms, regardless of the website's template. This feature gives Act 1 and other AI systems like it an advantage over traditional automated scripts that can only cater to a specific website template. Adept claims to be working on general intelligence, which they define as systems that do anything a person can do in front of a computer. The CEO, David Luan, also stated that the impact of natural language assisted tasks will be similar to the shift from command lines to GUIs. The way you can interact with your computer without memorizing a list of short keys and commands is the same level of abstraction you would apply when using language to perform digital tasks.
Anything that you can do on your machine by asking your computer to do it in language.
And in so it's a text-to-speech, and then that speech is, or audio, I should say, and the audio then is translated to help build the AI models.
So you can either type, what you want to do, or you can say it, and then you can do things like, you know, boring near-term stuff, like take these 16 profiles I found who I might want to recruit and put them in my applicant tracker, all the way to like crazy long-term things, like I want you to go build a financial model for a business I'm thinking about buying, or like create a part for an F1 car. Like those are things you should be able to say and just have a computer do for you. And that's what we're building. And to us, that's what general intelligence is.
This might seem like an episode of Westworld, but we have labs across the world working on this challenge. Things that seem very difficult to do are becoming increasingly easier to achieve using large-scale language models. The concern, however, about these AI systems is that they may execute tasks that we actually didn't intend or perform malicious tasks on behalf of the user. Although AI agents like Act 1 are very promising, diligent cybersecurity and privacy standards will have to be maintained to usher in this new era of computer interactions. What do you think about AI digital assistants, and what would be the number one thing you would use such a system for? I'll leave links of projects discussed in this video down below in the comments section so that you can explore them some more when you do have the time. We also discuss how large language models are currently used to write code. Here's a link to the video. You can explore the other interesting topics we cover on this channel as well, like AI videos and AI telepathy. Yes, AI telepathy, it's a real thing. Exciting times. Thanks for watching. Until the next video, it's goodbye.